The first stop on our Kenyan safari was the Old Tukai Lodge in the Amboseli National Park. The grounds were unique because of the large population of baboons and monkeys that lived there. If you didn't deadbolt your door, it would open just by pushing on it. The baboons knew this, and they got into several rooms of our mates and made quite a mess. Amboseli is near Mount Kilimanjaro, and it formed a perfect backdrop for our photos. The park is home to large herds of elephants that come out of the forest every morning, heading for the marshes to forage. They spend the day there feeding and return to the better protected forest for the night. This young lady was very fastidious. Watch her rinse off the grass before eating it. Several mothers and their babies stayed a bit longer at the marsh to feed some more. This mom came right up to the truck, watched us for a while, spread some mud around, and then slowly headed back for home. They say that serval cats make affectionate pets, but they need a lot of TLC, can weigh up to 40 pounds, and live for 20 years. So we didn't bring this one home with us. In Nairobi, we visited rescue centers for giraffes and elephants. These young giraffes had their own special way of greeting us.
back in the year 1877, after the death of David Chaudry, who was a naturalist and the senior founder warden of the large Savo National Park. After his death, this project...
Our restaurant for lunch served up some interesting and exotic meats, and a few of us even tried everything. Our tented camp in the Masai Mara was special. Hot showers, bed warmers, all the comforts of home. We came across these camera crews fairly often.
Last long?
No. I was gonna say, that's pretty fast.
Malaika is a very successful cheetah mother with four teenage cubs. We were witness to two of her kills.
She's chasing. Okay. She's taking the wheels of base.
She's even rushing. Okay.
Oh, she's God.
Got something? Or?
Yeah, she's. She gave up.
She gave up?
Yeah, she gave up. She's still being. Yeah, she's still. Up. No, she's still.
It did rain some, but very little. Our safari was in February, one of the dry season months. The rivers were low, so our animal crossings were not like those you see in all the nature programs. But I thought they were interesting anyway. We followed this pride for about a kilometer when we saw this beautiful leopard behind a termite mound. She stayed there for quite a while, then meandered off. Not far away was her cub, and he provided us with some excellent poses before running off to chase some elephants. This big male struck a few poses, wolfed a bit, and then headed straight for our trucks. He walked right beside the one I was in and plopped down about 8 feet away to root around on the ground. This little guy was lame. He had a bum right front leg. It was a little before sunrise when I snapped this photo a few seconds after Malaika had taken down a gazelle. The Maasai chieftain said that they were going to abandon this village in the next few weeks for a new and larger one that they'd built nearby. Unfortunately, it wasn't quite ready for visitors.
Yes, the lady. Okay, go join them. Join them. Yes, join the warriors. Okay.
Oh yeah, yes.
Before you come back for that.
These men showed us how they could start a fire without matches. I remember this from my Boy Scout days. It never worked for me. Their huts were made of wooden branches and covered with mud. The one we saw had four rooms, one for cooking, eating, and meeting, one for the parents, one for the kids, and another for their baby cows. This woman showed us how she prepared a dish called ugali, which is usually made from cornmeal. One day we had lunch on a high bank above the river and looked down on hippos and crocodiles. And in the midst of all this was a mother goose and her babies.
This is video, guys. You can move, you can talk.
This is great because nobody's negotiated a price yet. So we have over here.
Have to get a model released.
These were our drivers. Mamai, who is second from the left, was our lead driver. He is a Maasai. I asked him what he did when he wasn't safari driving, and he said he went back to his village and tended his cows.